Hi guys, my name is Lady 11 and I am a medium. For those of you that don't really understand what a medium does, is that they can communicate with spirits and interact with them. And a lot of people actually just kind of hire a medium and they just kind of like, they have these abilities, but I don't really understand how they got their sensitivities or their abilities. And I recently became one, and I wanted to share my story as to how a person becomes sensitive to the energies around them. It's actually an extraordinary story, and I wanted to share mine to make sure that the people that are going through very peculiar situations understand that they are not by themselves. I am putting my face out there to let you know that, yeah, you're not the only ones that see visions. I saw visions 8 years ago of my niece that was not even born yet. Her face was at 3 months old, and my sister was 3 months pregnant. So I was driving in the car and I saw a face, and it looked exactly like my sister and her husband, a perfect combination. And I called up my sister. I was like, "You're gonna have a baby girl." She's like, "Good guess, considering that I'm pregnant." I was like, "Okay, we'll see. And a year later, there she was, as beautiful as ever. My first niece, she is now 7, so big. But that was one of the many extraordinary experiences that has happened to me recently that I wanted to share with you. You're not the only one that sees numbers. You're not the only one that sees, that has sensations, chills. So yeah, you know, and it took a traumatic experience for me to spiritually awaken this gift of mine. I actually had to do some background research, and turns out that starting with my dad's generation, I am 4 generations of fortune telling. And my dad knew about my gift when I was born. He knew that I would have the gift of seeing the future and seeing what would happen to different people. But he didn't tell me. So I was like, and so I had a very normal upbringing. I was basically there was bullying, there was friends, there was no social media. Thank God for that. But it was actually very normal. And I actually didn't start experiencing peculiar things until 8 years ago. And I started seeing patterns where the visions that I would see or dreams, they would manifest the next day or a few days later. I would see a ship sailing, and then the next day I would actually see a movie about it. It was actually, I started seeing patterns. So I was like, okay, maybe I am just more sensitive than others. I can actually see what others can't, maybe. And then I realized that I never told my father about my gift. So I told him, I was like, "I see visions." And like any other father, they'd be like, "Everybody sees visions." And then he just opened his eyes, like, and just was very calm. He's like, "What do you see?" And I told him, I was like, "I see things, and things would happen the next day." And then he was like, "Okay, all right. So, what else do you see?" I was like, "Well, I know that there will be a boy, and then a girl, and then a boy." And then turns out that I foresaw every single sex of the baby in me and my husband's family. And so far, I'm 7 for 7, which is bananas. For some of them, I would know the sex and the name, and other times I would just know the sex. But it was all really astounding. After I started connecting all the dots, it started becoming more clear that something was happening to me. And then 4 months ago, I went through a traumatic experience of going through a separation / divorce. And to cope, I went into meditation, like a lot of us does, right? And after meditating, I noticed that my abilities, my sensitivities are getting stronger and stronger. Now, to go back, my grandfather, he was an astounding character. He actually had amazing fortune telling skills. He actually had lineups out the door to people would just line up just to talk to him, just to see what their fortune was like, what their destiny would look like, would they be able to leave the country. It actually at one point became illegal for you to fortune tell in Vietnam. So he put up a front, he set up a noodle shop, and he allowed other people to sneak around the back door and talk to him. He refused to let his gift be wasted, and my father's theory is that he sent it from the beyond and into me. So I'm very blessed to have my grandfather watch over me, but I do not believe in revealing everybody's destiny. They have to live through it. The lessons, every single lesson equals to something. So, yes, every single episode from here on out, I'm going to let you know what happened to me in the last 4 months. It's very peculiar. It's very fascinating. And that's why I was told to go on YouTube and share my story. So, if you have ever had a peculiar experience, I would love to hear it. I set up an email. It's called lady.1100@gmail.com, lady.eleven00@gmail.com. And so I'd love to hear your story and I'd love to share mine. Every single week, I'm gonna be sharing most of them are about hauntings. The following week, it talks about a cowboy in a 100-year-old building. So it's pretty interesting. Now I'll give you a little teaser. One of the events that triggered my spiritual awakening happened on February 11th. So I collect candles with rings inside. And what happened was that the previous night, I burned it all day and there was no ring. So I was like, okay, fine. You'll reveal it tomorrow. Whatever. I left it on the stovetop and I went to bed. And I was laying in bed and right at 11 was two door knocks on my door. And I was like, okay, this is scary considering that the only person that lives with me is right sleeping. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna go to bed. I'm just gonna go to bed, forget about it. The next day, my candle was lit. I immediately texted my husband. I was like, hey, did you light the candle? Did you want me to reveal my ring? And he was like, no, it's dangerous. And I was like, of course you would think that. Of course. So the ring was revealed. And there it was. It's very pretty. So there it was. I wear it as a good luck charm. And it's strange things that happen like that, that escalated me to have this gift revealed. It blossomed like a flower. So yeah, if you like to tune in, I would love that. No hateful comments, please. anyways, 11 signing out. Have a blessed day.